issue. I have now to use a Spanish keyboard on a Windows machine. I'm a Linux user with a fresh install. So I guess we will have a more interesting time than I planned for myself. But I think it's also a good challenge to see how stable Android actually is. Is it okay from the acoustic? Can you hear me? All right. So welcome again. My name is Lars Vogel, and I'm founder of a little company. We are approximately 5 to 6 people, depending how you count. And we do development and training in the area of Android and Eclipse. I also like to write and explain things. I have published a few books now, and also have a website which has a lot of traffic, like 1 million users per month. I only have 6 slides, except I have some failover slides if live coding for some reason doesn't work with this machine. But I want to show you how you can actually develop Android application. The plan was to start very simple with the basic stuff and then extend it a little bit more. So we will just see the wizard to create an application, probably try to deploy it on an emulator. We also will then leave the standard development and develop our own custom views, so our own widget components. We will then talk about integration of components, and we see some permission issues. And if time permits, we look into animations. And all this may change if this machine doesn't cooperate with me. It's a Windows machine, and I have not a perfect relationship with Windows. Although it's not a Mac, I don't like Macs at all. So let's start with some base concepts so that you can actually follow. I'm going to show you the visual components of Android application. So there are a lot of things which I'm not going to show, given the time. I'm talking about only activities, and activities are the visual components of an Android application. So whenever you open your email or your Facebook application or whatever on your Android phone, you see a screen, and this screen is an activity. An activity can be very complex, very simple. Typically, you have a layout file or some XML files which configure your activity, and you have a Java class with some source code in it. So let's see this. Completely fresh Eclipse. Let's see. Let's first see if my emulator started. This is very good. So let's start building an Android application. I think I don't care. I decided I will build against the latest Android version. It doesn't really make a difference, but tend to be a little bit stable. The new wizard now allows me also to create a nice icon for my application. I can choose between different templates. And once I'm done, I'm basically... I have to install something, and then I have a running application which I can immediately deploy on my device. Let's see if this works. If it works, it will create a project and create all the structure needed to deploy this application on a real phone. Let's look at our real phone. I have now here a pre-configured phone, also fresh, completely untested. I also hadn't had the time to configure it a little bit more nicer. So you see that this has a hardware keyboard which you can use. But it's a full-featured phone running in the emulator. I also didn't have the time to make it faster. Usually you can set a few flags to make it really smooth now, but we have to live with a slower version. By the way, the setup doesn't give me a lot of chances to cheat. Usually I prepare something to have a backup, so now I'm without a backup plan. All right. So while the project is created, you see that there's an editor opening. It needs some time to load on this machine. And once you see that, the default layout will be started. Looks really good white on white. You see that there's what we call an action bar. some white background and Hello World included in it. Let me just change it to a different style. So that it's a little bit more visible for you. That is exactly how my application or my activity will look like if I start it. So it's basically a Hello World application like we know if you're programmers, hopefully you are. So I can now use this editor to edit my layout file, which is connected to the activity I talked about earlier. I want to have an image. I want to have an image. All right, thank you. Okay. Doesn't work here. Let me try something else. All right, let's try this by hand. I hope code completion is working today. Image button. So let's say I can copy it from here. Seems to be working. Let's go for a button. So let's assign a text to this button, say click me, or clicks. Let's see, at least it renders it well. Let me just try this one more time again. No, it doesn't work. So I basically have now a button in my layout. I could just take this program, right mouse click, run as Android application. Yeah. And it would deploy it and start it, no surprise, right? At least it should. No, it doesn't. All right. Okay, let me try to reset the connection. Oh. All right, it works, it's just incredibly slow. Sorry for that. So I have a very large button here, which I can click. It basically extends to its maximum size, and I would like to add some interactivity here. So the thing I can do to my button is that I can connect it with a method in my Java class. So if I go here and say on click method, the property of this button on click should map to a method on click. I can go to the source code of my activity. And create a public void on click method. All right. And here I should be able to create a toast. Sorry for this, the keyboard is really unusual for me. Usually I'm a good typer. And let's say it's, make it a little bit here, silicon colon is here. Hello. Let me try to deploy that again. Obvious. Oh, yeah, thank you very much. All right. Yes. Let me just try one thing. Okay, something is already there. So basically, I have now a little bit interaction here. If I click this button, it should actually call this method and should show this. Might be a little bit delay again. Yeah, I think the result will be no surprise. I basically click the button and there will be a little text message be shown. So that is usually the normal way of developing things. You can also let me try something else. You can also work without layouts. So if you want to show a list of things, you can use a different type of activity. You can just say, I don't want to use an activity. I want to use a list activity. You create a list of strings, a new array adapter. Adapter four. This Android. Layout. Simple list item. Input. And once you have done this adapter would map the input to the view. You can just say, I would like to use this. In your activity. So what I did now, I created a little data structure, very simple strings. I said I want to have an adapter which maps this data structure to the UI structure. I'm going to show you soon a list. And then you basically activated this list. So if this starts, hopefully, we should see now a list of items where you can scroll and click with three lines of code and without any German or English keyboard, which I am able to use. So these are the standard things you usually do. You basically take the visual editor, which usually works, drag in your components, connect them somehow, and you then build up your logic. Or if you don't want to have a layout, you can basically define it in your coding or use some templates, which makes it easier for you, right? So this is like the simple stuff you usually do. And this shouldn't have taken that long, actually. So sometimes you don't have components or the system doesn't work and it doesn't hear. So let's say, for example, I would like to use a component on which I can draw, right? So I would now like something which was the topic I actually announced when I issued this talk. I would like to have a simple component where I can use a touch event and paint on it. Right? So I could now look through this list and try to find one. There is none. There is not a component where I can just draw upon. So for my little kid, I would like to have some component like this. The nice thing about Android is you can easily extend it. Let's say you would like to have your own view, my little or my finger draw view. And then you can extend the base class of Android, which is view. We need a certain constructor. and you say, on this view you would like to draw. For drawing you need two things. You need a paintbrush to draw. So what is the width of what you would like to draw, which color you would like to draw, and you need something to draw. Let's say we would like to have a list of points. All right. Getting better with this keyboard. You would like to have save a list of points which you would like to connect. So whenever I touch the display on my virtual device, it should remember this and start drawing what I'm going to sort. So I have a path which allows me to save this, and I need also a new paintbrush. I want to have a little configuration. I would like to have it blue and a certain width and height. Actually, I should have created this as fields, so I can convert it to fields. So now I have everything basically which I need to start drawing. Drawing is done in the onDraw method. I get a canvas here, and canvas is known today, right? So in the HTML world, it has been invented by Microsoft, the canvas drawing operation. So this is basically the place where I draw. This is my drawing board, canvas. So on canvas, I can draw things like Control Z very well. I could draw, for example, draw a color. And let's start with yellow. I put in the alpha value. I say then it's yellow. Come on. And now I have a view which always will be yellow, right? But it's a little bit boring, so what I also would like to have is an onTouch method. OnTouch contains a motion event, and the motion event contains all the data of all fingers on your screen. Depending on your device, you have support for 10 or more, if two people working on the same device, fingers which are on the same display. So I basically say, okay, I take care of this touch event. And I'm only, because on the emulator anyhow, I can only have one finger, the mouse pointer, I'm going to work only with one event. So I get, one event is easy. I get the X and Y coordinates of my event. Event. And let me just correct this here. Now I basically can use this information to do something. I would also like to know what happened. Did the finger move? Did it went up? Did it went down? This is also contained in my little event here. So I can actually switch event get action, I believe it's called. Let's say motion event action down. So what's wrong here? I guess I have to type that again. I have hidden the override button, and I have no idea where to reset that. So what's wrong here? Syntax error. Just reuse that, switch. And get action. Sorry for this. So I basically want to say if the finger goes down, I move my path to the new coordinates. I'm not drawing anything, I just move it. And if it's if the motion event is action move, I'm going to draw a line. And I'm going to tell the view that it needs to redraw itself. So currently I'm not using the information I have created, right? So I remember where the finger has moved, I remember where it has went down, I'm not using it. Canvas has a lot of drawing operations, so I can just say Canvas, draw path, and it will draw my path for me. So that's basically it. I think I correctly implemented the view from what I can see. I also would like to now to use it. So what I do, I basically revert my little activity from list activity to a normal activity again. And instead of using a layout file, because this doesn't work, I assign it directly to my set content view, new my finger something, this. And that's also possible, right? You can work with layout files, but if a layout file editor doesn't work, you can also program your layout manually. Usually not the preferred way, but at the moment, an easier way for me even to fix this other thing. So I started it. You see that it's getting yellow, and I hope I can draw on it. Yep. So now I can actually draw on this little thing, right? That's nice, I hope. It's also, at the moment, I have a menu here where I can actually trigger something. It uses an old-style option menu because I have created an emulator which has a hardware keyboard. So it's not as fancy as I wanted. But I also would like to show a different concept. So we have seen activities. We have learned a lot about Spanish keyboards. And we've also seen how to create our own components. What we have not yet seen is how to actually use other components. And that is a very important and very strong point of Android. You can seamlessly integrate different components into your application without having a hard coupling to these components. And that works based on intents. Intents allows you to describe what you would like to do. And once you have described what you would like to do, you send this to Android. And based on the information you have put into this intent, which is just a message, Android will figure out what your intent is and start the things it can start. Or offers the user a choice if there are several options. Let's try to implement this. I do have, I believe, already a connection to my menu. So I can actually say that if this menu has been selected, I would like to do something. So let's say I would like to share something, right? I'm misusing now the menu, but I would like now to share something, some text. Sharing is a very easy operation. If you have an Android phone and you are the normal average person today, you have like 10 social networks where you're actually being active. Every social network application, your email and so on, will be available for this share intent. On the emulator, we have only one component, and I think we try later to build a second so that you actually can see the choice. I should have actually started this while I'm talked. So what I now did is I said, whenever the user selects this menu option, my only one at the moment, I would like to trigger this intent. The intent says, do something which is sending, action send, which is the first line here. And I would like to send text. And I put some extras in which the receiving component can actually evaluate based on the contract it defined in its Java doc. So then it can evaluate that. And let's try this out. So I think I saw an error message, which is usually not a good sign. Let's see. Locket, console, It's either really, really slow or not doing what I wasn't, I should have pointed out that I should actually send it to the Android system. So let me just do this. Obviously, just describing my intent doesn't work. I also need to tell Android that I actually would like to do this. And there's a method start activity where I send this data object container to it, and Android will evaluate it and figure out what to do with it. So let's try that again. We like to start the menu, we start sending. On this virtual device, we have only one application registered for this intent. So it starts immediately, which is the SMS application, right? So now you see some extras had been sent. It was just a text message. And the application uses this to evaluate that. So let's try. And I think that might be risky, but I tried anyway. Let's try to build a second component, which we would like to also register for this intent. So where you can see actually that you have also sometimes a choice. Let's try to do this in the XML file. To register for new intents, you basically define a certain intent filter. It should be sent. And the category should be default. And I think you also have to define a data filter for text plain. So basically, I have now said I have another component in addition to my SMS installed application. And I also would be willing and to work with shared data of type text. Let's see if this installs. We should see a hello world again. Hello world. So whenever I have now installed a second component. So now if I go back to my other component, and I trigger this intent again, it should give me the choice, because we have now two components installed on our system which work in the same way. And that's an important message, right? There are no second citizens or second class citizens on Android. Whenever you register for the same intent as any default application, you will be on the same level as this default application. If a user chooses to, he can use now my wonderful main application, always for sending his shared data by flagging this or selecting this always flag here, right? Very important. I have not implemented a hard coupling to any component. I have just defined that I would like to share something. And if someone has now a Twitter application, Facebook, this will also pop up. So this worked well. So I think that's a good start. But let's try to integrate another component. Let's see. Gallery, let's see if we have something to pick from the gallery, otherwise this demo would not make sense. There is nothing. We can make a photo. hopefully. Yeah, I think it's starting. Sometimes on certain laptops, it actually connects the camera of a laptop with the emulator. Doesn't work here. So otherwise you would see my happy face twice. So SD card is full. That is not a good message for us. Let's still try to connect to this application. Because what I would like to do is actually pick a photo and connect it to my drawing application. The SD card is full on this device. We will try to set up a new device and start it. And we make it a little bit more beautiful so that the setup is maybe worthwhile. So let's say new device. Has a little bit more SD card so that it's not full again. I define a resolution myself. And I'm also saying it has a certain pixel density. Should not have any hardware buttons. Actually, good demo. So I'm happy that my laptop doesn't work here. So what else? And I make it faster. So this may take a while to start up. So hopefully in 5 minutes we can continue working with this emulator. So we have now two phones very soon. It starts soon, hopefully. Hopefully it doesn't crash the machine. I expect it to start up anytime soon. So let's just continue. I have a menu, and I would like to add another menu entry to that. Menus can be defined in code as well as in XML. We choose the XML path because it's easier. We have a menu settings already predefined. Let me add another menu here. Let's say it's a menu, and I call it pick. And I also put it in the action bar if that works. Let me just for later create another entry here. No, it doesn't work. Okay, that is a Windows shortcut which I think flips the display. Let's see if I can revert that. It's also a shortcut in Eclipse to copy a line. I don't find it very useful to flip my display, so usually if I have to have a Windows machine, I turn this off. Let's see if I can actually repair it. All right. Fortunately, I had this. Okay. Please stop now. All right, I create another menu, let's say save, just in case. And I also say save here. And I say here if room, should work. Meanwhile, my second emulator tries to start, hadn't successfully done this yet. If I start this, I can actually decide on which emulator it should start. I take the one which is running. And hopefully I see now a little bit different application soon. What I expect is an application with 3 menu items. If this works also well, I should also see the so-called action bar, which is on the top of my application. At the moment I see nothing, very good. All right, so this worked. I have now an action bar, which is a very useful paradigm in Android. So you see all the important actions actually on top of it. the reason why this phone still has this oldish looking option menu is because it has a hardware button here. If the other emulator starts, we will see how the system behaves if I have configured it differently. Obviously, there will nothing happen because I haven't programmed anything. Let's try to pick an image. So, let's see. I think I copy this one. Pick, or say, I'll pick. Great. And I want like to pick something. Again, I have to specify what I would like to pick. And I actually have to start an activity. This time I have to start it with a different way. I have to start it with start activity with result or for result, because now I actually am interested in whatever has been picked in this other application. If I call this, there's another back call once I return on result. On activity result will be called whenever I have picked an image. And now I can start processing that. Let me see how my emulator is doing. It's starting, so. But I think at least I can demonstrate it to you how it would look like. Let's just start it. I'm not using this result yet. Takes a little bit while. I think I'm almost done fighting with keyboards. So I'm just want while this we wait for this. Let me see. No, it still doesn't start. I try to prepare something else. Object. Animator to. Float view rotation 45 degrees. Find by ID. So where do the Spanish people keep their ad? No, I think this will also not work. Sorry. This was not as smooth as I planned. Sorry for that. I think the setup didn't really work. I plan to stop here around and answer questions. Again, very sorry for this. Laptop switching, different keyboard, different setup. We had 10 minutes to set up a system without any testing. So I think for this, I'm happy that I could show you something. And we still have time for questions. So if you have any questions, please feel free to ask them now.
when you develop for Eigenmind, we use a device for testing the application, or we always use the emulator?
I think the question was, do I use real devices for testing, or do I use the emulator? Is that correct?
Because when I tried to use the emulator, I got different behavior from real device.
Usually you are advised to test on real devices if you can afford it. What we usually try to do is to test at least on 3 or 4 device configurations, real device configuration. So at least a tablet, at least the smallest device you're targeting, then the latest like S3 from Samsung. If you have a restricted budget in devices because you're doing it on the side project, emulator works okay for testing. It's just relatively slow and it's not the same behavior as a real device. There are some areas where the emulator is actually outperforming the real device, which is especially if you do I/O operations. So if you do file access, emulator tend to be very fast, and on the real device you may face some issues with like application of responding dialogues and so on. So definitely get at least one device. I think if you can afford it, 4 or 5 devices would be better. Right. Any other questions? I don't think we have any other questions. Then I thank you, and again, very sorry for this. Didn't work as well as I planned to. All right, thank you very much.
Vielen Dank. Und nochmal sorry für das Durcheinander.
Kein Problem. Was von außen denn genauso chaotisch wie es hier empfunden hat?